My dad will kill me when he receives that report for Spanish words.
Yeah, I know. We better start speaking in English all the time.
You better get on, girls. The lonely girl that reached that amount of Spanish words ended up leaving.
Really? Could I get spelled?
Don't know. As far as I know, she expelled herself. She started speaking about a Spanish ghost and left.
Come on, she must be joking.
Of course, she just wants me to speak in English all the time.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, Emmy. I saw your new record on Spanish warning.
It's stupid. You should be on it too. You speak as much Spanish as I do.
But I have a good job.
Because I've just seen your record, and I'm not impressed. In fact, in 20 years teaching at Woodlands Academy, I've never seen the likes of this kind of behavior. Okay, ladies, so let's continue. Where were we? Page
99.
Okay, who can give me a quick summary of the story so far? That's it. I've had it. So right now, you are going to take yourself to Miss Marie's house and you can explain your behavior to her. Thank you. I beg your pardon, Julia. You can continue now in 2 minutes. Go on, off you go. Okay, so Julia, off you go. Where were we?
They just told her that she has 3 minutes for each call with the 8 times.
Come in. Amelia, I'm glad you're here. Have you seen your new records?
Yes, I have.
And?
I am sorry.
Are you really sorry?
Yes, I am, but sometimes it's so hard to speak in English.
I understand it's hard, but you know this is an English-speaking boarding school, right?
Yes.
So, as a consequence, you will stay back from the outing this week and work hard.
No, Miss Maria, next week is a party with a boys and I need to buy a new outfit.
I am sorry, I hope you learn from this, Amelia. But from your misbehavior in Mrs. Quigley's class, you need to go to the garden and reflect on your actions and apologize to Mrs. Quigley.
What are you doing here on your own?
I wasn't here to think.
You better go back inside, it's too cold.
I think I saw someone.
You go on in, I'll have a look.
Eddie, where we can step on the bridge?
A tree fell during the summer. It's not the first time this happened. It's a dangerous place, so off you go.
My friends and I would like to take pictures there.
Don't even think about it. Now go inside, please.
Are you okay?
I'm tired of getting Spanish warnings.
Spanish warning, Emilia. Emilia, you can have a Spanish warning. Everybody hates me. Come on, don't be dramatic. Just focus on the party, okay?
I'm not going to the outfit. I won't have an outfit.
Don't worry. Focus on the Portugal trip. It's coming soon.
Come on, that's in 1 month.
Girls, guess what? I saw Roberto again, and he gave me this letter and chocolate.
Wow, that's so romantic!
And what will you give him back? I don't know. I don't have any candy to send.
I can help you to get some from the kitchen.
Really?
How are you gonna get in? They won't let you.
At night, silly.
But you will get in trouble. You're in enough already.
That's why. I'm in enough already. Necesito relajarme.
Did I hear some Spanish in this dorm?
No. We were speaking in English.
Really?
Are you sure this is the only way to avoid a security alarm?
Cállate y sigue avanzando.
Sí, está funcionando.
Sí. Girls.
This is not happening.
¡Vámonos, tonta!
Girls, if anybody is awake, it was a false alarm. Don't worry, stay in your room.
Who was it?
Miss Bain, of course. Who else could it be?
At that time,
she stays all night to supervise.
Then why did we even try going to the kitchen?
I thought that she would be sleeping.
What will happen tomorrow? We'll be punished.
No, we'll convince her not to tell Miss Clarion about it.
Girls, she's coming.
I'll be the one doing the talking, okay?
Hello, girls. You look very tired today.
We wanted to talk about that.
Don't tell me you want to miss your sports class to take a nap.
Well, didn't you hear something strange last night? Some of my friends were feeling sick.
And why didn't you come looking for me? It was very calm last night. I was wondering why it's so quiet now. I was sitting on the couch. Who did you say it was sick?
Oh, they're feeling much better.
Oh, well, I'm glad to hear that. You better be off.
Miss Bain, just wondering, do you ever use a candle? I think I saw someone with one, or maybe I dreamt it.
Must be all the movies you've been watching. I never use a candle, it's a fire hazard. I have my torch. Now, is there anything else?
No.
No, it was so nice talking to you. We must go.
Okay.
Thank you.
Girl.
Don't even think about telling her. She didn't realize it was something.
I think she wasn't the person we saw.
Okay. Amelia, Spanish warning.
Danny, why didn't you tell me?
You were too excited.
Well, the point is that I saw someone and then it disappeared.
I don't know what to say. This is weird, weird.
Okay, girls, about the alarm that went off last night. Well, it seems that it was activated by the wind. But just in case, a reminder, if you walk outside your dorms to the corridor leading to reception and to the kitchen, the alarm will sound. And if you wake up the whole school, there will surely be a consequence. So last night it was the wind, but it's a reminder just in case. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, so going on to the next topics.
Ben, no era Miss Ben.
Bye.
Shh.
In English, Amy has to make Spanish
Danny,
warnings.
This is getting serious.
I know, you can't just keep missing outings.
No, I mean, yes, I have to stop speaking Spanish. But about last night, the alarm was activated by Ana Gaby, not by the person we saw.
Oh, this is getting creepy.
Tell me about it. I have an idea. Why don't we go and ask all the staff what were they doing at 2:30 a.m.? Maybe someone went to the kitchen and felt hungry.
At 2:30?
Yes, we went to get food at 2:30.
But it wasn't for us, it was for her querido Roberto.
Maybe you are right, and Ana Gaby should be the one asking the staff where they were.
No, I can't.
All of this was for your querido Roberto.
Okay, all right, I'll do it.
I was sleeping.
Excuse me?
Sleeping?
I don't know. Maybe I was asleep.
Me? I'm sleeping!
I was fast asleep. Have a nice dream, maybe.
So, any news?
No, they all looked at me as if I was crazy. Nobody went to the kitchen.
Okay, I have had enough of this. We have been stupid. It was probably nothing. I have to go to my swimming desk.
I need to go fight.
Bye, girls.
Bye.
Please, Miss Carrion, don't leave me here on my own. I can't stay alone.
Emmy, come on, get up. You don't have to be on your knees. And you won't be on your own. Miss Lucky is here with you.
No, please, I beg you. I can't. I won't speak Spanish again.
No. I believe you. But you have spoken Spanish. So you have to stay this outing. Hopefully it will be the last one. Come on, Miss Lucky is up in the library waiting for you.
Good luck, Amy. Everything's gonna be all right.
Good luck, Amy. See you later.
Come on, everybody, to the buses. Let's go.
Amelia, this is your work for today. I'm going to be here working and supervising. Okay? Okay, Amelia, I have to go and get some coffees, all right? I'll be right back. You carry on working.
Can I go with you, please?
No, you stay there and you do your work.
Miss Lucky.
handbook on ghosts. You were reading this? I wondered why you were so scared when I left, was leaving the room. Come on, get on with your work. You've got 1 hour to finish all this.
I was alone in the library.
Roberto,
what are your name?
And that's not all. A book fell and a candle appeared.
A candle?
Yes.
That's weird.
Like that one.
If you don't believe me, go to the library and see. There is a candle exactly the same as this, and a book that fell on the floor when I heard the steps.
I will go. See you in the room. Let's
watch. Well, I will show you what I got.
Girls, this is what I found. The book was open on this page. When a ghost uses a candle, it means that it's looking for something or someone.
Give it to me.
How to chase a ghost. Page 10. Pepper. Throw pepper to the ghost. Number 2. Salt. It works only for vampires.
So, we're convinced that there is a ghost.
I am, and I am not crazy.
Do you think he's looking for Roberto?
Or maybe Roberto on Agavi's love.
Why are you talking about my Roberto?
We are not.
You're hiding something. What is that book? What is this? A book on ghosts? You're going to confiscate it.
It was in the library.
Did you see a ghost again?
Finally! Someone sensible!
Was there a ghost in the school? Now?
We don't want to scare anyone.
Good night, girls! Time to sleep!
Now I won't be able to sleep.
You won't be the only one.
Girls, I can't wait for Sunday.
Excuse me, neither.
I'm so proud of myself. I haven't gotten a Spanish warning in 2 days. I will make it and go to the party.
Wow. Congratulations, Amy.
Girls, I think that today is a perfect day for our pictures in the garden. Look at the day.
I'll bring my camera.
Yes. Let's do it.
Okay, girl, smile!
Girls, and if we take a picture in the bridge?
Yes!
No, girls, we can't.
Yes, let's go!
Yes, don't be a party pooper.
Let's go!
Una selfie para que salgamos las cuatro.
Sí, va. Vente. Niñas, ya es hora. Vámonos. Córrele. Córrele.
Gabi, this is the worst joke ever.
What joke?
The pictures. Why? I thought you would like to have one on your board. Oh, I didn't do it, I promise. I'm not in the photography class and I know nothing about Photoshop.
Are you serious?
Show me that camera, I want to see the other pictures.
She's seen all the pictures. So creepy.
Hey, what is it?
Oh, the picture from our classroom.
I can't be.
No way.
Let's go and see if the canoe is still there.
Are you crazy?
No way.
We have to. This person, I mean, this ghost, I don't know who, ruined our pictures.
Okay, but let's burn the pepper.
And the salt, just in case.
I don't think it's a vampire.
We'll get them.
Where are you girls going?
To the dining room.
To take a shower. And where's your stuff?
And result, just in case.
Se cayó el agua.
Girls, what's that?
Back there, really.
We should tell an adult. Yes, we should. We have evidence, the pictures.
No one will believe us. Girls, I think we should investigate. Who lived here before? Someone must know.
Tomorrow I'll ask Miss Travers about it. She's a history teacher and must know something. If she does, I'll show her the pictures.
That's a good idea. I will go with you.
Yes, me too.
Me three. Girls, it's time to go to class. Let's go.
your homework diaries. And don't forget, fill the notes from pages into your copybook for homework tonight, okay? Thank you, girls. See you later.
Thank you, Miss
Travers. Make sure you have that down before you leave.
Travers, could we ask you something?
Sure.
It's personal.
Okay. What's wrong?
Miss Travers, do you know who lived here in Woodlands before?
That's not a very personal question. It was the Wingfield family. This is why the house is called Wingfield House. They were a noble family who owned the Powers Court estate.
Do you have more precise information? Was there a boy called Ruperto?
Ruperto? Ruperto is a Spanish name. I don't know. Maybe one of the servants? I'm not too sure. I can get you the genealogical tree if you liked. Why are you girls so interested anyway?
Well, we were just wondering because this is a very old house. Why was the house old?
I'm not sure. Things were not going well on the estate. The family moved back to England and some Spanish families moved in. I hear there was a tragedy that got to the families as well.
A tragedy? What kind of tragedy?
I don't know.
Well, thank you, Miss Travers.
Okay. See you later.
Bye. Bye. Thank you.
Strange.
Something.
We heard something.
What? What do you mean?
Yeah, we heard a voice, kind of creepy.
And we went looking for a supervisor.
And I freaked you out, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, don't worry. You probably just heard like the wind howling, and you thought it was a voice. So, just go back to bed. Don't worry. I'll give you a blessing. Okay.
Bless your name to protect you. Good night. Don't worry. I got bless your name to protect you. Good night. Don't worry. You'll be fine.
Thank you.
Okay.
The party on Sunday. I want to see Sebastian.
Hey girls, no more paranormal activity, right?
You're such a nerd. Who will use that enormous word for a ghost?
Some of us happen to have a more extensive vocabulary.
Whatever.
Girls, I still don't have an outfit for the party.
Don't worry, you will find one.
We will help you.
Yes. Okay girls, you're
Bye.
Okay, boys and girls, welcome to Dublin Oak. We're going to begin our tour now.
These are pictures of the castle before being an academy.
The Spanish family, Fernandez del Castillo, lived here nearly 100 years.
The last member of the family was called Don Ruperto Fernandez del Castillo.
He never married, so when he died, the castle was given into auction. And that's when Dublin Oak moved in.
Ana Gabi, are you okay?
I think I need some air.
Come, let's go, we'll get you a Coke.
So, let's go to the next part.
Let me help you.
What are you doing here?
Taking a picture.
And what do you want that for?
For a print of history.
Okay, well you're gonna have to explain that to your director.
No, Father, please, I beg you, I have enough problems already.
All right, I'll take you back to the party, but if I catch you out again, you're gonna have to answer to Miss Clarion.
Yes, thank you.
Good morning, girls. It's Monday.
I can't believe I got so night with Sebastian.
I dreamt I married Roberto.
Oh, you're so cheesy.
I don't care.
Hey, today is the 1st of April. Our Spanish warnings are erased.
Woohoo!
And what are we going to do with that?
Roberto.
I just want to forget about that story. I will keep my iPhone with me just in case.
In case we can show the picture to Miss Travers and find out more about him.
Today I have prepared a class on the Wingfield family, from the Wingfield house, because a lot of you seem like really interested. Okay? Okay, so I'm just going to hand out a few of these. You want to take family trees. Paul Miller. Paul Miller. Yes, Amelia.
Miss Travers, you never mentioned why did a Wingfield move?
Ah, well, that remains a mystery.
Oh my gosh, she's the one. She died. And look, she was only 16. There must have been a terrible accident or some sickness.
It must have been tragic. She died a year ago and has moved back to England.
Just like Romeo and Juliet. She was probably in love with Ruperto, and never who lived in the castle. That's why he never got married.
So, do you think she committed suicide?
Could be. That's so romantic.
That's not romantic, that's pathetic.
So, if she committed suicide, is she still looking for Ruperto?
Because if this is like Romeo and Juliet, she must have been told that he was dead.
There's only one way to find out. If there's a ghost in this house, we cannot be the only ones to see her. Eddie!
Yes. The first time that I saw her, he pretended that he didn't see her.
And Bernie, she told us about a girl that talked about a ghost and expelled herself?
You can't expel yourself. Whatever, the fact is that she left Woodlands.
Mrs. Quigley must know about her.
Okay, Anagadi and Sophie, go and search for Eddie. Me and Danny will go to talk with Mrs. Quigley.
Let's go.
Take a seat. How can I help you?
Miss Quigley, do you know if a girl was expelled because she had too many Spanish warnings?
From Woodlands?
Yes.
Yes. Well, I think it was more that she couldn't handle the situation. So that's really all I can say about the situation right now. Why? Are you afraid of being expelled?
No, she is afraid of ghosts.
Of ghosts? Why? Have you ever seen one?
No, well, I don't think so. Thanks a lot, Miss Quigley. Thank you.
Okay, girls. Take it easy.
Danny, how could you tell her that?
Sorry.
Hey, that's funny.
No news.
He's saying nothing. Every time we try to ask him something, he closes up like a tomb.
That's it. What? Do you want to look for her grave?
Normally the newspapers announce who passed away.
We gotta go to my team later.
Let's go.
Oh no, niñas. Miren esta foto. ¿Qué onda?
No way.
Wingfield family suffers tragic loss. The Wingfield family lost their 16-year-old girl in an accident. Apparently, the girl was walking outside in the middle of a storm when a tree fell on her. The guardian is still on the case as they haven't found her body.
Oh my gosh, look for the next day.
Ay, se nos va a acabar el tiempo. 18 de noviembre de 1948.
¡Nada! ¡No hay nada al respecto!
La siguiente fecha en la que sale la familia Wingfield es el 15 de diciembre. Wingfield family heads back to England. The internet stopped working.
Girls!
It's Ricky.
Before Ivy had had the pepper with us.
Yes, not the salt. She doesn't look like a bad boy.
I know.
Tomorrow I'm going to go to talk to Miss Clarion.
I'm not going with you.
I think you should go on your own.
I'll go with you, Emmy.
No, thanks, Danny. But Anna-Gabby and Sophia are right. I think I should go on my own. If she thinks I'm crazy and wants to send me back home, I will be the only one affected.
That's a good idea.
Come in.
Good morning.
Hi, Miss Clio. May I ask you something?
Yes, of course. Take a seat.
Well, if someone is searching for someone and she comes to ask for your help, will you help her?
Is this a kind of riddle, Remy?
No.
Well, I think I would. I would help her.
Also, if she was a ghost?
A ghost? Have you seen a ghost, Emmy?
I think so.
Well, you're not the first person to see a ghost.
Really?
Yes, I'm actually sick of these stories of the ghost. If you can somehow get rid of her, I would be more than grateful.
Well, I'll try.
Good. Don't be afraid of her. Next time you see her, just ask her what she needs.
Well, yes. Thank you, Miss Clarion, for your help.
Have a good day, Emmy. Bye.
Bye.
What are you doing?
She wants me to get rid of her.
Really?
Let's follow what the book says. What? Do you have a better idea?
Let's escape through this window. It is open. Come on.
Are you sure this is the best place to do it? It's kind of creepy.
Yes, we don't want to wake up anybody. And the book says it has to be in a private place.
What else does the book say?
How to summon a ghost. 1. Go to a private place. 2. Bring the paper with you in case you're scared. 3. Call the ghost by its name.
Margaret Rose Wingfield, where are you? We want to help you. We have something important to tell you about your Roberto.
Niña, soy tu profesional.
Call her, Sofia. Again.
Margaret Rose, we won't scream again.
Maybe in Spanish?
Hola, Margaret Rose.
Roberto.
No somos Roberto, pero sabemos dónde está su castillo.
¿Roberto?
Sí, mira.
My beloved Roberto. I've been looking for you ever since the accident.
Accident?
Didn't you commit suicide? No, it was an accident. I was in love with Roberto. We fell in love the first time we saw each other. My parents didn't like him because his family was taking over our family business. I didn't care about the business. He loved me. And I loved him. So every night on the bridge, we would meet. But one time, I told him that the following night, I would be going to his castle. At first he refused, but I insisted so much that he had to accept. So the following night, just before 3 a.m., I went out of the house. There was a huge storm. The wind was so strong I could barely move. When I was crossing the bridge, the wind made a branch fall, hit me, and I fell into the water. My dress was so heavy, I drowned.
Why did you do that?
To see if it worked. As soon as I drowned, I came out of the water.
Stupid book.
Still looking for my Roberto. And I've been looking for him ever since.
We can take you to his castle.
Really? You would need to show me the way. Last time I tried to get there, it didn't work well.
Coming. Roberto!
Girls, Emilia, what are you doing here?
Oh, Ana Gaby, you didn't have to come all this way to see me, and in pyjamas?
I like you, but I wouldn't risk my Woodlands ear for you.
So, did you come to see someone else?
No, we came to bring a ghost.
A ghost?
Good luck with her. Could you please help us to get back? We don't want anybody else to see us.
Yes, come. The academy is behind those trees. You'll see it soon. Thank you for this lovely surprise.
I didn't come for you, but it was nice.
I love you. I hope that meant something.
What did he tell you? That he likes my PJ, silly boy. You love him.
The weirdest night of my life.
And romantic.
Very funny.
No more ghosts.
Shh! Someone is coming!
Girls? Sophie, Emilia, Dani, and Ana Gaby. What are you doing here, girls? Everybody's having breakfast.
With the team.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
We will never speak in Spanish again.